Speaking of our family prayer, shall we all sing the hymn, Jesus, Lover of My Soul.
Jesus, Lover of my soul, let me to thy bosom fly. Why the narrow waters flow, why the tempest still is high, hide me, O my Savior, hide, till the storm of life is past. Send me to the heaven-guide, for is it my soul at last. Other refuge have I none, hangs my helpless soul on thee. Leave all me not alone, still support and comfort me. All my dress not in stained, all my help from thee I bring.
Good evening. God has blessed us with this beautiful and wonderful evening. In this evening, we will meditate a few things from Psalm 16. I read that psalm for you. Keep me safe, my God, for in you I take refuge. I say to the Lord, you are my Lord. Apart from you, I have no good thing. I say of the holy people who are in the land, they are the noble ones in whom is all my delight. Those who run after other gods will suffer more and more. I will not pour out libations of blood to such gods, or take up their names on my lips. Lord, you alone are my portion and my cup. You make my lot secure. The boundary lines have fallen for me in pleasant places. Surely I have a delightful inheritance. I will praise the Lord who counsels me. Even at night, my heart instructs me. I keep my eyes always on the Lord. With him at my right hand, I will not be shaken. Therefore, my heart is glad and my tongue rejoices. My body also will rest secure, because you will not abandon me to the realm of the dead, nor will you let your faithful one see decay. You make known to me the path of life. You will fill me with joy in your presence, with eternal pleasures at your right hand. Keep me safe is the cry of David in this psalm. He is asking God to protect him. He surrenders totally into God's hand. He surrenders himself to the Lord totally. He says, I say to the Lord, you are my Lord. Apart from you, I have no good thing. First he says, keep me safe. Keep me safe. For that, he tells God, Lord, without you, I have nobody to protect me. In today's context, most of us say this, Lord, save us. We are going through a difficult situation. The virus is spreading very fast. Protect us, save us, keep us safe. This is our cry. The Bible gives us a lot of assurance and promises. Bible always talks about not worrying about tomorrow. The Bible tells us that tomorrow will worry about you. You need not think about tomorrow. When we get hold of this kind of assurance and promises, God would make that promise as our own. We can depend on that promise. God would bless us according to that promise which is given to us by Him. In Matthew chapter 10 verse 29 we read, are not two sparrows sold for a penny? Yet not one of them will fall to the ground outside your Father's care. Without your Father's knowledge, nothing will happen even to the sparrow which is sold for 2 pennies. In this world, remember, God has some plan for each and every one of us. Unless and until God fulfills that plan, nothing will happen to us. That assurance we should have. In Matthew 10:31 we read, don't be afraid. You are worth more than many sparrows. Don't be afraid. Very often we are very scared. We are not able to sleep properly. Our BP is going up. We are very much tensed up. There is no peace. We are very scared. We are not able to move around freely. We keep on watching news and we are very much disturbed. We do not think about God. Please remember one thing. No one will manufacture a lock without a key. No one will manufacture a lock without key. Similarly, God won't give problems without solutions. There is a solution God has given us already. Depend on Him. Believe in Him. Claim the promises. I'm very sure this problem will vanish very soon. Don't be scared of future. God says, tomorrow will worry about you. We are not created to worry about our earthly survival. It is the responsibility of God to take care of us. As the father takes care of his children, God would take care of each and every one of us. Depend on Him for everything. God would give us the right solution in the right time. So do not worry about future. Many times we are very much disturbed. What would happen? How this problem would be solved? Like David, only one thing we'll ask God, Lord, keep me safe. I have no one except you. All of us should remember, we are created by God to fulfill His will. We should not worry about anything. Think about the Creator who is the Almighty. Depend on Him always for everything. I'm very sure, as David says at the end, we also can say that my heart is glad and my tongue rejoices. My body also will rest secure. In verse 9, that's what we read. My heart is glad and my tongue rejoices. When these kind of things will happen? When everything goes very, very peacefully. When we have peaceful atmosphere. When we enjoy blessing, our heart would rejoice. May the good Lord bless us with wonderful day so soon, so that we can continue to rejoice in Him. We can continue to praise His holy name. Depend on Him. Believe in Him. He will give us the right solution, and He would lead us in the most righteous path. God bless you. Good night. Let us pray. Loving Heavenly Father, we thank you very much for this wonderful evening which you have given to us, Lord. We thank you for keeping all of us safe and sound thus far. It's all because of your grace and love we could successfully complete this day. And as we are getting ready to go to bed, we come to your presence to thank you for all the good things which we enjoyed all through this day. Lord, it's all because of your love, grace, and compassion we could complete this day. Lord, as you are looking for a bright future, Lord, help us not to worry about the future. Rather, help us to depend on your promises. Help us to claim all the assurance and promises which you have given to us in the Bible, so that without any difficulties, without any pain or tension, we can face the tomorrow. We know that before we reach tomorrow, you would be there. You would be going before us, and you would be preparing the path for us. Bless us. Grant us good rest in this evening, and help us to get up early in the morning to glorify your good name. Lord, we commit all our friends and relatives and our family members at your keeping. Be with each and every one of them. Give them your peace. We pray for the people who are very much affected with this infectious disease. Lord, we ask you to stretch your healing hand, touch them, heal them completely. We also pray for those who have lost their dear and near ones for this plague. Lord, be with them, wipe away the tears, give them your peace, so that in the days to come, Lord, we may forget all these difficulties and pain. We can overcome this difficult situation with your support and with your blessing, and we can continue to lead a peaceful life. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Shall we all join together in the Lord's Prayer? Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of Father, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all now and forevermore. Amen. God bless you. Good night.